COVID-19 rising again in Asia. Will it affect the US? For the most part, COVID-19 cases are steadily declining worldwide. But we're still in the Omicron wave and likely staying for a while because of the BA.2 subvariant. Some countries in the East, like Hong Kong and Singapore, are experiencing a surge of new cases. Will this spell brand new trouble? Will it affect the US? Singapore has imposed a zero COVID policy to effectively control new cases. The policy consists of strict rules including border control, contact tracing, mass testing, quarantine, and self-isolation. However, the policy isn't foolproof as Singapore experienced a surge of new cases. The same thing happened in Hong Kong and New Zealand. The culprit suspected by experts is the stealth Omicron or BA.2 subvariant. A study uploaded on MedRxiv showed that BA.2 is more transmissible to the original Omicron or BA.1. But the study didn't fully observe the increased transmission among people who have been fully vaccinated and already received boosters. The data from other parts of the world suggests that BA.2 is highly contagious, but not more severe than BA.1. University of Texas at Austin professor Lauren Ansel Mayers told Medical News Today. The increased transmission might be true among the unvaccinated or not fully vaccinated. In the BMJ, a study revealed that while Hong Kong implemented a zero COVID policy, the death rate skyrocketed and at one point had been labeled the world's highest in a 7-day period. The spike was from the largely unvaccinated elderly population. Two powerful forces are at play: complacency and vaccine hesitancy. Complacency seems to augment the existing hesitancy. During the peak of Delta and Omicron waves, most people felt the pressure and they got bold enough to overcome hesitancy at some point. A big chunk of the unvaccinated population took up vaccines to share the perks of the vaccinated, like indoor dining and indoor activities. When cases begin to drop, fewer people are getting vaccinated and more are getting smug. Experts see upticks here and there, but the full-scale surge remains uncertain. BA.2 is kind of late to the party. Many were exposed to BA.1, and combining their natural immunity with vaccines, BA.2 may not cause much of a ruckus. That's what happened in the US. People may still get sick and experience mild symptoms, but massive hospitalizations and deaths are less likely. The theory right now is that upticks of new cases are expected. Meanwhile, another surge will likely rely on the current state of community-level immunity. Populations with high vaccination rates and encounters with previous variants are more likely to dodge surges. Are COVID cases in your area still rising? Is BA.2 strain common in reported cases? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.